Hey guys, it's not very hard to clean a throttle body, but there are a few things you need to keep in mind, a few precautionary things. This is an electronic throttle body, drive-by-wire system. It's not like the older type of systems. There's no physical wire attached from your accelerator pedal to the throttle body. It doesn't have the traditional idle air control valve. So if you are having idle problems, then you should clean your throttle body. Here you can see the RPM drop to around 500 to 550. This RPM drop only happens when the engine is on load. So when it's really hot outside, the aircon is running at full speed. I'm coming to a stop, I disengage the clutch, and this is where the RPM drops. Now the car never stalls, but it's pretty annoying because the car does shudder when this happens. Before you remove it, it's a good idea to take a picture to see where the various hoses connect. You do have coolant lines that go to the throttle body. This helps prevent it from freezing in, you know, very cold temperatures. Be mindful of that so that the coolant doesn't spill everywhere when disconnecting the hoses. Now, I've seen local mechanics do this, and even online, they will drown this in petrol or throttle body cleaner to clean this. A lot of throttle bodies have molybdenum coating on the hinges. This is a throttle plate with hinges on both sides that connect to the main body. When you spray too much throttle body cleaner directly on it, eventually you may erode this coating, and this may lead to a sticky throttle plate. So in that case, you most likely have to replace the whole thing. When moving the throttle plate, don't be aggressive, be gentle, take your time. And be careful not to get your finger pinched between the throttle plate and throttle body, it does hurt. Spray some throttle body cleaner onto a microfiber cloth and start cleaning. This way you won't get any cleaner inside the hinges. I also like using a soft toothbrush. I spray a bit of cleaner on it and this helps agitate the carbon. There is quite a bit of gap now. So basically, as I said, this is an electronic throttle body. The plate has to be kept slightly open to ensure that the idle speed is maintained. So when there's a lot of carbon buildup, it does kind of mess up. Cleaning the throttle body does help with the RPM drop, but still it may happen even afterwards. And I've noticed that this happens again when it's really super hot outside, the aircon is running at full speed, when it's nighttime and the headlights are also on. So the RPM may drop. Once cleaned, put everything back in the same order. When it comes to Honda throttle bodies, we need to calibrate it again so that it learns the idle position, the proper RPM resting position. If you do not do it, your idle RPM will be erratic, it will not be stable, and it may fluctuate even during driving. Every manufacturer is different, so do check with your manufacturer if such a procedure is needed. You can do this procedure yourself, but if you're having issues or you're not sure how to do it, you can go to any mechanic or even the dealer that has a proper diagnostic tool, and they can run this idle relearn procedure through that. Make sure that everything is off, the blower is off, aircon is off, the radio is off. If you can't turn the radio off, just keep it on mute. Now to begin with, insert your key and turn on the ignition. Do not start the car. Wait at least 2 seconds before starting the car. Start the engine and hold it at 3000 RPM until the radiator fans come on. After that, let the engine idle for at least 5 minutes. If the fans do come on in between, do not include that in the 5 minutes. So probably just let it idle for around 6 to 7 minutes to be on the safe side. Okay, 98 degrees, the fan should be turning on now. Yeah, you see the temperature drop, so I'm letting go. Sometimes it's a bit hard to hear the radiator fans, you know, with the engine running at this speed. So I've let go of the throttle, just let it idle for, again, as I said, 5 minutes, not including radiator fan time. Now in between, it may happen, and it does happen to me at least once, I lose acceleration, so it does drop below 3000. Do not worry about it, just accelerate back up when you can to 3000 RPM. Thanks for watching.